Boston City Councilor Josh Zakim picked up a big endorsement today with U.S. Congressman Seth Moulton backing his bid to unseat fellow Democrat and sixth-term incumbent Bill Galvin as Secretary of State. Zakim's big problem, though, Galvin will barely acknowledge he exists. So how much does an entrenched politician owe their opponent in a primary challenge? Adam Reilly reports.
The Bill Galvin-Josh Zakim contest has already had plenty of drama. In December, Galvin called Zakim sneaky for announcing his run for Secretary of State right after winning re-election to the Boston City Council. In February, Galvin reportedly lashed out at Lawrence Mayor Dan Rivera after he endorsed Zakim, allegedly telling Rivera, "I made you mayor." And just this month, after the Boston Globe reported that Galvin's staffers were working for his campaign on the public dime, Zakim basically said Galvin can't be trusted to run an election he's also running in.
We have, you know, nationally attacks on our democracy, and for Massachusetts to be a place where there could be any hint of impropriety is just unacceptable.
What this very juicy race hasn't had, at least so far, is a debate where the two candidates share a stage and challenge each other directly. Zakim says he's game any time.
Every contested election I've been in, whether as an incumbent or as a challenger for an open seat, we've met at a forum. And I think it's something that people expect and that voters are entitled to.
In March, Zakim publicly challenged Galvin to six debates, one for each month left in the campaign at that point and for each term Galvin has already served.
We were both in the same room and I said to him, I said, Mr. Secretary, it had been about 5 or 6 weeks after the challenge had been issued. I said, did you get our invitation to debate? And he said, yes. And that was the end of the discussion.
Today, Zakim says he's still waiting, and the primary is now just 3 months away.
I think it shows a real disdain for the democratic process. I think it's clear Secretary Galvin believes he is entitled to a seventh term.
I wanted to run that charge by Galvin and get his take on the campaign. But when I stopped by Galvin's statehouse office, they referred me to this campaign email on Galvin's website. After two messages sent there got no response, I hand-delivered an interview request to the Bill Galvin Committee in Brighton.
So I'll take this inside and see if I can get anyone to respond. So I just had a brief conversation with a lawyer named Anthony Donato, very nice guy. He told me the Galvin Committee gets their mail dropped here and picks it up from time to time. He took the letter and said he'd put it with the rest of their stuff for the next time they come by.
A week and a half later, crickets. So we're forced to give the last word to Josh Zakim, who says if a debate ever does happen, his top priority is asking Galvin about the Chelsea Collaborative versus Galvin court case.
That's a case that the ACLU brought that struck down our 20-day registration deadline in Massachusetts. The Superior Court judge, in striking it down, called it arbitrary and unconstitutional, ordered Secretary Galvin to do something better. And instead of taking that opportunity to create a same-day registration system in Massachusetts, as 17 states and D.C. have already done, the secretary appealed that decision.
For the record, we'd still love to get Galvin's side of this story and maybe even get him and Zakim to engage each other directly before voters head to the polls. Adam Reilly, WGBH News.
As a matter of fact, tomorrow morning we will invite both Secretary of State Galvin and City Councilor Zakim to join us here together on Greater Boston.